U.S. Supreme Court to hear Biden's vaccination rules. Legal objections to President Biden's COVID-19 vaccination mandate for healthcare workers and big enterprises with at least 100 employees will be heard by the Supreme Court on Wednesday. On January 7, the Supreme Court has set a special expedited session for oral arguments in two sets of cases, as the country faces a rise in new COVID-19 infections triggered by the new, highly transmissible Omicron form. OSHA's requirements for major enterprises were the subject of one set of challenges launched by business organizations and Republican-led states, who requested immediate Supreme Court intervention after a split panel on the Sixth U.S. Circuit Court ruled the regulations may go into force. It was contended that OSHA lacked the authority to impose the immunization mandate on businesses and states. As a result of two distinct rulings by the Fifth U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals and the Eighth Circuit Court of Appeals, the Justice Department has requested the Supreme Court to intervene in two separate challenges to its vaccination requirement for healthcare workers last week. Following a rise in COVID-19 infections at the end of the summer, Vice President Joe Biden proposed a number of measures aimed at stopping the disease's spread in September, including the vaccination requirements. There have been several judicial challenges to both immunization programs. The standards released by OSHA in early November compel enterprises with at least 100 employees to either mandate workers to be vaccinated against COVID-19 or to be tested regularly and wear face masks. When it was originally scheduled to go into effect on January 4, OSHA stated it would not begin issuing citations related to the standard until January 10, as long as an employer is making reasonable, good faith efforts to comply with the criteria. As many as 80 million workers might be affected, according to the administration of Vice President Joe Biden. Over the following 6 months, OSHA anticipated that the new immunization restrictions will save more than 6,500 deaths and avoid more than 250,000 hospitalizations. As a result, the new regulations were quickly challenged in federal courts throughout the country, and eventually merged in the Sixth Circuit, which contains 10 justices nominated by Republican presidents and 5 picked by Democratic administrations. OSHA's power wasn't expanded in a new way by a 3-judge panel on the Sixth Circuit. Instead, it used its existing power to deal with a new and dangerous global pandemic, the judges said. A previous Trump appointee, Judge Joan Larson, dissents. Following a regulation issued by the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services, CMS, in late November, a second batch of lawsuits revolve around obligations for workers in a broad variety of Medicare and Medicaid-covered institutions to be vaccinated. First dose of the COVID-19 vaccine had to be administered by December 6, and all workers had to be completely vaccinated by January 4, according to the new regulation. Workers who have not been vaccinated are not required to undergo daily or weekly testing, although medical and religious exemptions are allowed. About 17 million people would be affected by the vaccination requirement, according to the Biden administration. In federal court, a number of states argued that Health and Human Services Secretary Xavier Becerra exceeded his power by implementing the vaccination requirement for healthcare employees. A federal district judge in Missouri halted implementation of the requirement in those states, and the Eighth Circuit refused to overturn the lower court's decision, which was challenged by 10 states. Finally, a federal judge in Louisiana halted the regulation from going into force nationally in a separate action filed by 14 states, but the Fifth Circuit limited the ruling to the 14 states that had sued the Biden administration. Supreme Court justices were requested to allow vaccination mandates to go into force in 24 states where they are presently being stopped by lower courts. The Omicron variety of COVID-19 has prompted the Biden administration to defend its immunization mandates as necessary to safeguard employees and patients against the disease. In the United States, Omicron has surpassed Delta as the predominant strain, accounting for more than 73% of infections, according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC.